I left yesterday after the screening, and the movie is fantastic, by the
Thank
way.
Thank you.
And I found myself hearing things I hadn't heard, paying more attention to noises. Yeah. Have you changed in terms of the way you hear and listen to things?
Absolutely. It really is true. It's a weird thing. I remember we started out joking when Emily signed on to the movie. We made jokes where if we were all cooking for the kids and I dropped a spoon or something, she'd just be like, "You're dead." And it was funny, but then you started really investigating. It is really difficult to live in, you know, total quiet. And again, it's not a silent movie, it's quiet, which is a big differentiator for people. The crazy thing I learned was how much sound we don't hear during the day. So for instance, there's the scene where we're walking through the woods, and just something that simple, I think if you asked me to list 10 things I can hear in the woods, I'd be able to list two. Mm-hmm. Then when you actually sit there and the entire crew goes quiet, you're like, this is so beautiful. So it's that type of thing, especially in the world of tech where we're all like this all day. It's kind of nice to remember to take a little time out and listen to your surroundings.
I feel like the two of you would be great in this real life scenario now.
Oh, really?
But which kid of yours is the weaker link, you think, in terms
Man,
of silence?
I don't know. I don't think either of them would do very well. Our house is pretty loud all the time.
Yeah. When you want silence, where do you go? Is there a quiet place in your home?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I got to say, writing for me is my quiet place. It's a scary place. You know, writing's very difficult, as I'm sure you know, but it's really nice to just kind of check out and go to a place. And I will say that Emily and I do that in the parenting of, I'm just going to take 5 minutes and go away and come back. And it's really nice just to check out for a second.
Cut! Awesome!
You were the one who suggested that John direct this. Why direct it?
I think he'd sort of been looking for something to direct and wanting to do something very ambitious. And this just had every ingredient that I felt he needed.
How good is he at actually being quiet? If your family were going through this, is he the weak link or?
No, I think he's good. I mean, I think I would be the louder one. That, I think, has been really exciting, that people have come out and that the conversations have been about how heightened their senses were watching this film, because sound is the enemy to this family. That was cool that every scene was injected with some kind of tension like that. But yeah, I think it does make you very aware of how you normally would live and whether you would die living that way.
Is there a quiet place in your home?
At nap time. At night, yeah.
And that's about it?
That's about it.
I read that she actually at first recommended a friend of hers
Yes.
for the role.
Yes.
I want to know which actress buddy got passed over because of favoritism.
I can't say, but it was a quick decision. I mean, as soon as, I always wanted Emily to do it. 3 weeks before I read it, we had our second daughter, we had Violet, and so I was wide open. I was still terrified, hoping to keep her safe, hoping to keep her alive. Am I a good enough dad? All these themes are in the movie. But the truth was, she was doing Mary Poppins, a tiny little indie movie. And she had our second daughter, so she was very busy, and I also was really scared to ask her, if I'm honest, because I didn't want her to say no. That would be a very awkward dinner conversation. And then
right.
If she said yes, I really didn't want her to say yes for me. I didn't want her to say yes because this would be great for you if we worked together, and I just said, no, it's gotta be organic. So I actually didn't let her read the script for months, and then one day she read it and she said, nobody else can play this role. It was almost like she was proposing to me. And she said, I did. I said, are you saying what I think you're saying? And she said, yeah, I want to do the
movie.
Did
she have a ring? Did she open
exactly.
a box?
Okay. It was the script, and
right.
she opened it up, and I was like, oh my God.
Such a scary movie. Is it scary to film a scary movie?
No.
Okay.
Not to me, well, to me, I don't know about everyone in the world, but to me, no, because the creature's not there. You have to, like, play the emotion. So it does kind of create a little bit of fear. But because the set's so great and all the cast members are so amazing and everyone's like a big family, and the minute you get off set, everyone's laughing and making
right.
jokes. So it feels safe. It doesn't feel as though you think it would in making a scary movie.
Only a little bit, because every time I would see the creature, you know, I could imagine the creature. They showed us drawings. I could imagine what the creature would look like. That was my stimulus. I would respond to that. They would tell you where your eye gaze should be and where the creature would be standing. And then instantly you have to like pull up the response of what your reaction would be to that creature. And that's a little hard.
In this one, it's don't worry.
How hard was it to learn sign language, and how much do you know?
I have to say, I found it quite easy, mainly because of Millie, because I was always with her. And when I first met Millie, I really wanted to be, you know, I have a friendship with her because I grew up to like her. So that kind of boosted me to learn it. So it kind of got it quicker, and I learned the alphabet. So I could spell out the words, and she'd tell me, and we'd just be talking for, because there was like an hour to set, so we'd do it all the way there and all the way back.
Did he get good?
Oh, he's a terrible student. He's the worst I've ever had. I'm just kidding. Yeah. I was really surprised that he took so much time and energy to learn sign language, and he learned it in a very short time. I have other friends who, you know, have been very slow to learn sign language and not as motivated. But Noah, he just was on it right away and really wanted to know.
I hope more people are inspired to learn it. I know your interpreter is actually behind me. I'm assuming the same one that was on set. Is she a John Krasinski, Emily Blunt fan?
Oh, yes. And she was with me. She goes anywhere I go.
You've had some pretty tough scenes in films before.
Yeah.
You're kind of put through the ringer in this one. Are scenes that are that emotional and draining easier to do when your husband's watching this, or almost harder to do because he's right there?
Well, it's funny because I trust him so much and he trusts me, and so he also shoots very economically. He's like, I just need two takes of the scream, or like three takes of you getting in and out of the bathtub, you know? So the more intense sequences, and probably the giving birth sequences, like crazy. We shot it over a week, it was exhausting. He has my best interests at heart, so he also knows when I'm like running out of gas. So it was easier, probably.
You bring up the birth. I have to tell you, just the camera shot on your stomach, where we know that you're pregnant.
Mm-hmm.
The rest of the film, you're dreading.
Sure.
That day.
I know. Normally, pregnant women get complimented all the time about how glowing and lovely they look.
Right.
And in this case, they're like, no.
I don't know how anyone can be quiet during childbirth. Is there anything that this movie actually made you better at being quiet with?
No.
Yeah.
Probably not. I mean, I was so desperate to talk by the end of the day working on this, so no.
Who are we if we can't protect them?
She gives an Oscar-worthy performance, in my opinion.
Wow, I agree.
She really does.
I agree.
And I've seen her in everything she's done. Is it harder, though? There are such emotional draining scenes. Did you find that witnessing those firsthand was more difficult for you, seeing her go through this, or thank goodness it was the two of you working on this together?
I mean, it really is the latter, only because, you know, to be really honest, I didn't have much experience with childbirth. She seems to have better experience with that than me. But when you go through experiences like that with your wife, you know the true strength that it takes to be that woman and to be any woman going through childbirth and all those things. So I knew how good my wife was in every aspect of life. And so I wanted to be there with her. I actually think it would be a lot more awkward to watch a stranger do all that intense stuff and not be able to get in there the way I did with my wife.
And her real life childbirth experience was a little bit better than how it goes down
here? It was
here?
A little bit better,
okay.
Yeah.
So good, dude.
He's kind of a tough guy, your husband. He's tall, and you kind of think of him as this all-American kind of jock guy.
Yeah.
Has he gotten emotional yet now that this is done? Seeing this, the reaction that everybody's
having? Oh, I think it is emotional, and it's sort of overwhelming. It's like the dream-like reaction. So it's not something that we had planned for, you know. I always thought the film was spectacular, but I said, I don't know what people will think, because I never know. You never know what people are going to think, and the fact that people love it is like thrilling.
I sat next to some handsy friends yesterday. They jumped and they were very handsy.
Oh good, that's good. We want that.
Yeah, surround yourself with handsy friends.